Folks, look, sharper trades. We have about 50 minutes to the close. I have quite a bit of stuff going on this week, and I'm going to be moving in the next few weeks, so there's a lot of preparation. Anyway, doing the videos a little earlier. And so market, most likely, we'll expect a little bit of a pullback. So the by the end of the day, we should see a slightly different candle than what we see today. But anyway, so far, a very strong bullish reversal. Again, there's a 48 minutes to the close. And unless something major happens over the next 48 minutes, this thing could pull back a little bit, but maintains a very bullish look. 420, 430, 442, my next targets. The support is 410 and then down here 400, 401. The QQQ, the Nasdaq 100 ETF, also strong, decent volume. The hasn't broken out the all-time high yet, which is 342.2023. If you push through that, 350 and 364, support those set of lows, in fact, down here at 333, and then the 50 simple the moving average at 324. IWM for the Russell 2000, strong, got a bullish engulfing a few days ago, and today was able to pop the 50 and currently holding. Let's see if it breaks above this high, 226.54. Right now it's testing. If it pushes through there, then we could see the test of my target 232, and then this all time high at 234.53. Next targets 244, 258, and 272. Support 50 simple the moving average and those lows, 215, and then most important area we must hold is down here at 208. Dow Jones Industrial. More quiet, but still very bullish, side consolidation. The resistance target for me is 34,315. We are near there. Let's see if it pushes through. If it does, 35,000, 35,400, and 36,500, my next targets. The support, those lows here at 33,6, and then the 34 EMA, 33,200. Below that, the 50 simple moving average, currently 32,622. Transportation strong, tagging near my target at 15,173. To push through and extend, 15,800, 16,400. The support here is 15,000, and then the 34 EMA down at 14,500. Below that, the 50, simple the moving average, 14,139. Into the volatility index, the VIX spiked yesterday, but today is back at being quiet. It's forming some support here at 39. So let's see if that is a base for bounce the upside or rolls over. If it rolls over, the next support will be 34. If it bounces, 35. 50 simple moving average and 59, the next areas of resistance. And finally, VXC for the volatility. This is the midterm. The midterm has already formed the base and tried to move higher. Formed the base last week, 27, crossed back above it and might try to go up a little bit. So we'll see if he does that. If he does, the 50 simple moving average is the next resistance. Again, the fear maintains a very low level. Into the commodities, the oil. Oil breakout a few days ago, pullback the test. We'll have to think of this still in consolidation. Technicals have shifted to bullish after this drop. And with UBV back above the moving average, decent volume, not a lot to confirm the reversal, because again, for me, it's still in this consolidation. But as long as it remains above all the moving averages, especially the 50, this has a potential to go higher, 17, 2050, my next targets. Support 50 simple the moving average, and this low here must hold, 15, 27. And gold, the GLD, popped a few days ago, the mid channel, now it's pulled back and retest 165. So let's see if this area holds. For me, it needs to hold. That would be a setup for the next move to the upside. 117, one trend line, channel top. And then eventually, if it breaks 170. If it pulls back further and breaks below the mid channel, then the 50 is the next support that for me must hold. Break below that, 159, and retest the channel bottom, that would be near 156 area. A quick look at the silver, they're going very similarly. Silver also is now testing the 50 simple moving average there and needs to hold the break below a 21 simple moving average and the 200 simple moving average. Those are the next support areas. A break above this recent high at 24.74, then it could get bullish. 25.60 and 27.30 are my next resistance target if it breaks. Into the FANG, starting with Facebook. Facebook rally, pullback retest, rally, pullback retest. So it's bullish, and at least from the price level, but it's still below this, prior to this recent breakout, still below these highs, which was three or four. If it pushes through, it's a breakout. We have some kind of maybe flag formation, something like that. So it needs to break this area. If it does, look for a retest of the all-time high 315.88, above that 341.50 and 382. The support right now tight is this 295 area and then the 50 simple moving average. Below that, the 200. Apple popped, consolidated for 3 days, for several days, and today it made a bit of a move. Doesn't have a lot of volume to push through, but technicals are bullish, so maybe it's starting to point up. Let's see if it breaks out of this recent high at 135.53. Targets for me, 138, this all-time high, 145.09, 149, and then eventually 160. Support is 129 and the 50 simple moving average. The general area below that 120. Amazon similar pattern, bullish, good sign of consolidation with the support right now being at 3300. The next support level is the 200 simple the moving average, currently 3140. I'm looking for 3550, 3750, and 4000. Netflix had awful earnings a few 3 days ago and still bearish. It's below all the moving averages pointing down. This, I think, is going to consolidate and try to fill this gap. Let's see if it does it. But if it breaks below 500, the next support is this low, 485. And then if it takes out 485, 470 and 440 are the next support level. Looks weak. Lots of downward volume. Now barely holding the 200, which is a must hold area. And to close with the FANG, we look at Google. Google bullish breakout, at least at the moment, is breaking all time high. 23.18.45, 23.19.57, it's the current price level. 23.44 is my target, above that 24.55 and 25.77. Support, ATMA and 23.30, this is the basic area. And then below that, the 50. All right, into the individual stocks. We have a lot to cover on Friday. We have many that we accumulate. First of all, the official swings, obviously. Some of the swing ideas that are still active and strong, some even from a few months ago. And then some of the day trades that are still showing strength. All right, starting with Airbnb, this is all in alphabetical order. Airbnb maintains it's weak, obviously, because of this pullback, but it's in consolidation and starting to turn around, at least appears to be. So crossed above the VWP crossed the moving average. It needs more volume and is now at this support at 160, 165 area. Basically this low, 161.90. For me, that level needs to hold. Break below that, it gets problematic. It will retest this channel bottom. And if the channel bottom falls, then this thing will fall. But right now, I like the company, I like the technicals. And again, I have a long-term position for this one. Every drop for me, it's an opportunity to add a few positions. And so let's see when it breaks. If it breaks, it will be very profitable. If it breaks downside, then we keep holding. I do until things improve. And but from a swing point idea, it needs to come back above the 50 simple moving average, take out 195 and 200. That would be near this trend line. If it does make a break with volume, then this thing can fly. The longer the consolidation builds, the more the energy that is released when price breaks, the upside or downside, hopefully the upside. 220, 245, 274, 300, my targets. AI formula base at 58. The support is the 80 May and 58. I'm looking for 77, the 50 simple, the moving average near 89, 103, and this channel top, falling channel, 112. BI and BNGO, BN Nano Genomics. Formula base of 5, popped yesterday, came near the target at 710. Target was 710, came 695. But pullback, and inside that today, it is an indecision, but it's holding the support of 570. For me, as long as it remains above 570, with this kind of volume, it will try to go higher. 570 is the support for me, below that 5. Looking for 710, 8, 50 simple moving average, 910. And one more just for the fun of it, 1151. Very strong, but also very volatile. Very strong in terms of the volume the past few days. This is in knowledge. This is just something we are covering. BTX, today's day trade, incredible. Friday, we pick things as we go. This was showing very strong reversal at the beginning, and then immediately popped, consolidated, formed the base near 15, and then rallied to the next target, 1620. And 1878. Now this is done as a day trade. As a swing, if you happen to swing this extremely volatile company, the support is 14 and today low at 1130. Car is a swing, working nicely, reached the target a few days ago, a pullback, got a bounce of 42, going higher again. It needs to break, and all this is the all-time high, precisely 44.65. I'm looking for 47.50 and 51. Support remains the same, 43 and 41. They're both very tight, considering how fast this company moves, the upside and downside. And the most important area for me is the 50 simple. But again, 43, 41. Cotti breakout. This is a swing that is currently working rather well. The breakout, my first target is 1047. They came as high as 1016. Next targets, the first target is 1047. Next target, 1210 and 1383. The support, it's 9 and 840, basically the same. Crowdsource, a little bit of a pop today, confirming yesterday kind of reversal, but considering how strong the market moved today, this did not make much of a dent in the price action, but remains bullish. This is a swing idea. 330, 346, 230, 246, and 262 are my next targets. Support 80MA and then 200. Dash is a swing idea. Good action today. Testing the 50 simple moving average, volume is increasing. Technicals are bullish with this volume a few days ago. If he breaks all this 50, we'll try to go higher. My target's 163, 179, and 195. Support is 145 and 135. FCX reported earnings yesterday. A decent, reached the target a few days ago, steep pullback or bounce of the 50 simple moving average, a pop today. So maintains a bullish look. It's rather volatile, so trade cautiously. This is in the commodity as it's copper, so it's related to the price of the commodity. 38.69 is my target, which is already reached a few days ago. Above that, 41, 44, and 46. Support is today low and yesterday. FSR was a swing. The brief worked today, basically reversed yesterday. Maintains a bullish look. I mean, let me correct this. Today did a little bit of a bullish reversal, but still below the ATMA. This one to start working again. It needs to move back above this high at 1467 and then break out of Wednesday high at 1529. This is now just a swing idea, no longer the swing, as it was showing some weakness yesterday, took it off the list near what it was 1450, 1460 level. Anyway, this is a little bit of a reversal. The support is 13, what was it? 1380 and then 12. Let's see this low. 1290. Basically, today low and the Wednesday low. So those are the areas that for me must hold. For me must hold. 1520, 1640, 18, and 1957. Gold is extending. Technicals remain bullish. This is in all list. We just keep covering it because it's been very strong and maintains a bullish look. As long as the momentum continues, you could see 470, 550, and 640, my next targets. Support is today low and yesterday low. GGB is extending today to 620. Obviously, price is still moving, the market's still open. The support is the ATMA and five, let's see, ATMA and 550. I'm looking for 651 and 710. GMED, swing idea, it's extending a little bit, 7190. Target 74 and 80. Support is 68. That's the line in the sand for me below that, the 50. Hog reached the target at 47.84, a pullback retest. My target here is 51.87 and 55 moving forward. Support 80 May, that's 45.50, and then 46, and then 44. So 46 and 44, basically. HPQ reached the target at 37, 34, 37, breaking, and an all-time high. All-time high, making all-time high. Looks like wants to go higher. 35.80 and 37.40 my next targets. Support is the ATMA, and then those lows near 32.50. IBM popped pullback consolidation, quiet, but looks bullish with the volume 3 days ago reported earnings. 147, 158, and 171 my targets. The support is the ATMA, and then Monday low at 132.50. JetBlue, it's starting to move a little bit weaker, but got a bounce off the channel bottom. So I will look for an extension. My first target is 50, 2168. It's not weaker, it shows some bullish pattern, but the OBV needs to come back above the moving average. And then I want to see it above 21. 2160, 2320, and 25. My target support is the 50 simple moving average. And then yesterday low, sorry, Wednesday low at 1870. JCI breaking out 63.15, the current price. And 64.80, 67. My next target, swing idea. Support 60, let's see. 61 and 59 remains the same. 61 and 59. Juniper is a swing that is not working. I took it off the list, or I'm going to take it off the list. It's got a bounce off the 50 simple, the moving average. Tried to break out, failed. Now the technicals are still bullish with this steep or very high OBV above the moving average, but it's not breaking out quite yet. So we wait for the break, and the break will be this high. It needs to stick above 26.20. If it does, my target 27.58, 28.86, and 30. Let's see, we are not there yet. I like today's bounce, but needs more volume. So I think it's still in the list, but most likely I will. Let's see. Joanne pressing the IPO day high at 12.80, currently at the level. Technicals are improving. looking for 13.87, 15, 16, 17, 20. Support 18A and 11. KDP, a little bit of a move, very quiet, he's not doing much. I want to see a break above this recent high, all-time high, 36.45, 37.12, and 39 are my targets. Support, well, we have to say 35.50 and 34.50 for now. Laser, Luminar Technology, LAZR, discovered a few days ago, consolidated yesterday, popped today, was a day trade, also added to the string idea, reached near the target here, is 22.80, 22.50 is the high. I will expect a pullback, but if this thing extends 25, 27, 29, could go very strong. Big resistance here at the 50 simple moving average. Support off of the candle, 20, 30, and then basically today low, 18.80. Myrna swing idea, decent. 178 reached yesterday. If he breaks an old next target, 210 and 251. Support 80MA and 50 simple the moving average. Net is a swing breakout. It's working. My first target here is 87. It needed to break the 80 and it's currently doing it. So I like that. 87, 97, and 107 next targets. Support today low at 76. And then those lows, 76 and 70. NIO was mentioned a few days ago and maintains a bullish look, got a bounce off this channel bottom. I will look for a retest of the 50 simple moving average, currently 43. If he breaks through that, 45 channel top, and then above that, 49 and 53. Support is the 80MA and 36. Ancala, nothing to do. It popped yesterday, was a good day trade, but quiet day. If he does any reversal of the 80MA and goes higher, 13, 14, 60, 50 simple the moving average, 17. The support right now is the 80MA and yesterday low at 10:30. OCGN, this is an incredible day trade. Day trade yesterday, swing idea today, exploded through two targets, 11, 13, came as high as 13.60 and then imploded going into the close. So this most likely is done, big volume. So it was basically a swing idea of one day that reached the targets, 21, right? Anyway, very strong past few days, but I will expect a retest of at least the 50 simple. Be careful right now because again, broke multiple support within the daily chart, the one week chart. It does recover 13, 15, 18, and 22 next targets, extremely volatile. OI is attempting a break. The area I'm looking at is this high at 15.24. My target 16.33, 18.66, and 21.13. Support is 14. On is a swing idea. And a recent swing that stopped working, and it's a difficult one to trade, so I'm not even going anywhere near this company. But we cover it, some of you traded. It's a breakout, especially with the semiconductor and the shortage in the chip. There's a lot of potential for this sector to improve moving forward. We have a new one, UMC, cover later in the semiconductor. Look for a retest of this high, 44.59, targets 45. 70, 49, and 52. Support is the 50 simple moving average and 39. Pfizer reached the target at 39.27, tagging 40 nearby. Pullback, it's holding the 80MA. If it breaks below the 80MA, we'll retest, look for a retest and pullback of 37. 80MA primary support, 37 secondary support. Targets, if he's able to break an old 40, 41 and 43. REL, an incredible day trade today, and also swing. This one, folks, if you remember, was covered a few days ago when he made his reversal, right at this level, consolidated today. When it was pressing the trend line, I posted as an official swing, and then immediately reached the first target, and it came to 7.17. Pullback retest. Those are new targets, the one that I posted in the remind, those are the official targets. 783, this is the target, the recent high, there will be a big resistance, that's the second target. If you push through that, 9, 9, 14 and 11. Support, 6 and 6 and 5. This is very volatile, so trade cautiously, but very bullish. Look at the volume. Starbucks coming off some support here at 115. Next targets 123 and then 131. Support 114 and then down here at the 50 simple moving average. SKLZ, back in the scanner a few times. Massive move a few days ago, 3 days ago. A big pop and big reversal yesterday. So keep an eye on it because it's forming some kind of base. And so far, it is forming the base. And the base is the ATMA. Looks bullish. At least this is a bullish Arami reversal with the volume. Needs more to confirm. Let's see if it pops an old 19. Target here 20, 21, 70, 23, 50. And the 50 simple moving average at 25, roughly. The support is the 50, the ATMA, basically today low, 1640. Below that, that gets problematic. It will come out at S14. Spot had a positive coverage today. In analyst giving a target of 360. I added to the swing idea. I like the volume today. I like the bounce off the channel bottom and a bullish kicker. It needs to break in all the 50 simple moving average. Now all the moving averages are behind except for that one. If it does and confirms the volume, look for a breakout of the trend line. 315, 339, and 367 are my targets. Support is the 50 simple moving average. And then 3 days ago, low at 260. SQ, quiet, above the moving averages. Technicals remain bullish with the OBV above the moving average and small volume, though. What I don't like much is that the moving averages are pointing down a little bit. But it's all in the support at 240. That for me is the line in the sand. The break below that, the next support will be at 220. So let's see if it takes out this resistance trend line. If it does, 267, 286, and 309, my next targets. United Armor popped today, confirming the reversal that we got 3 days ago. So this is a swing idea that started to work. Let's see how far it goes, because this also is another one that's very painful, difficult to trade, like OM. And if it does extend, my first target is here 1985, and then this recent high at 2130. Break above 2031, sorry about that. The next target will be 2135 and 23. Support is the 34 EMA and 1850, and then below that, 1720, this Tuesday low. UFPI, this was covered today as the lumber prices are going higher again. This was one of Steve's infrastructure list. Very bullish, popped yesterday, steep pullback, and now it is reversing again, so it looks like it wants to go higher. 83, 86, and 89 if you're trading it. Support is the ATMA and a few days ago low at 76. UMC, this is a swing initiated. The volume is good, breakout of this trend line. This is in the semiconductor. It's very volatile, came from 830, double bottom, popped the 50, pulled back the test, popped a few days ago. And now it's going up. So let's see. I will expect some pullback, especially if the market pulls back. But any extension, my first target is 1128. And then above that, if it's able to break out of this resistance, this thing can take off. 1274 and 1452. The support, what is it? 10? I don't have the level right now, but go with the level I sent in the remind text message. For now we'll call it 10 and the 50 simple moving average and 920. But again, please refer back to the message I sent. UMFI's quiet, still in consolidation, reached the target a few days ago, steep pullback, briefly broke the support, and then got the bounce of the 50 back above it. So this is still a valuable trade, but still in consolidation, so vulnerable to possible break. It needs to break the trend line. And what I want to see is a move above 38. If it moves above 38.20, then we have a possibility for a good run, 41, 44, and 49. The support 34, 36 and 34. 36 and 34. WFC strong day today, a swing, reversal 3 days ago, piercing line with decent volume. And my target here is 45, 32, above that 48 and 52. Support 42 and 40. Wrap. Gorav pointed this out, and it was moving early in the day and then made a massive pop. So this was incredible, very strong. And then a steep pullback, it's holding the VWP as we go into the close with 19 minutes to the close. Could be a reversal. This is CAPS technology, so we know this CAPS tension might be benefiting this company from that. They have alternative ways to arrest and that kind of stuff. 667, 771, and 881, 889 if you reverse. So the support here, this is added to the swing idea, is the 50 simple moving average and 5. XXII, what an incredible swing. We enter here, what was it, 370, and then explosive today, reached the first target at 444, took out this recent high at 466, and tagging 5, 521, in fact. Peels them off. My second target is 559, above that 7 and 860. Well, the support right now, we'll have to say, we'll have to update it. 460, 450. 450 and today low, 4. 450 and 4. Zillow swing idea is starting to work. I like the technicals starting to improve a little bit. The OBV needs to come back above the moving average. My target here is the 50 simple, the moving average. That's the key area. If you push through there, that first target 156, above that 180 and 206. Support is 130. 130 and then 125 for simplicity, basically those dots. Below that, 180. And finally, Zen. Zen, swing idea is very quiet, not doing much, but big volume yesterday. I want to see a break and hold of this recent high 152.52. If it doesn't, my target's 166 and 184. Support this recent low 144, and then those lows down here at 137. All right, folks, that's it for this week. Have a great weekend, and we'll see you on Monday. Good weekend.